Hey, what's going on? It's like super early in the morning here. Getting ready to go on a big toy hunt. I've already started tearing this down. But yeah, just getting ready. Watching some G1 Transformers. But it's time to get on the road, start this hunt. So we're getting ready to head out here. It is absolutely garbage out. Welcome to a Canadian winter, I guess. But we're gonna get going here. First stop is gonna be St. Jacobs. We're gonna go see 3D Vintage there. And then we'll see where else the trip takes us. But I'm gonna deal with these winter garbage weather roads here and we'll get to where we're going. So we made it to St. Jacob's Farmer's Market and we're going to go inside and see Rob at 3D Vintage. It's been way too long since I've been down here. We'll see what kind of deals we can get inside. So we're inside and let's go see if we can find his booth. So we made it through the blizzard into 3D Vintage and St. Jacob's Farmer's Market. Here's Rob. He is the proprietor of this establishment. It's been too long since I've been down here. I usually get some good deals. But yeah, so he's got all sorts of goodies here. You got the Battle Cat. What do you got on him? I might, 15 bucks? Yeah. I think I might take that. I'm looking to do a custom on him anyway. All sorts of goodness here. Like I said, he's down here in the St. Jacob's Farmer's Market. Do they consider this Waterloo or is this...
Waterloo still, yeah.
Yeah, we're in Waterloo. There's a gray skull, the APC. All sorts of good stuff here. Darth Maul, who doesn't like Darth Maul? South Park. Got tons of stuff here. So if anybody sees anything, do you ship?
Yep, I can totally ship, man. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram.
I'll definitely. Toys. Cool. Yeah, I'll definitely put a link in my description to your Instagram and Facebook. But yeah, he'll ship stuff to you.
And we're open every Thursday and every Saturday.
Every Thursday, every Saturday.
Yep.
Down here, got some cool stuff down here too. Pretty much whatever you would probably be into, I think, is in this booth. That's a cool Batmobile, Brave and the Bold, I think.
It's but, the 1984 Superpowers
here. Is it really?
Yeah.
So there you go, there's an 84.
Batman and Robin.
Yeah, Batman and Robin. Clearly off to go get some ice cream or something. Because that's what they do. Oh, I need that space raft down there. Be talking to Rob about that one afterwards. And here's a good one too. Got some Thundercats, Leech, Motu. Oh, there's Robin Hood. The infamous Friar Tuck, the Gamorrean Guard. Yeah, I do need that Bucky O'Hare gorilla dude. Some more Motu, got some G.I. Joe, M. Bison, Hardball, that was his name.
Remember those things, that black and blue front, Snailians?
Snailians?
Yeah.
No. No, I never heard of Snailians, actually.
Pops open, there's like a little snail alien thing inside.
Oh, really? That's cool. Oh, Who's that? That's Mork, isn't it?
Yeah, Mork from Mork.
Mork from Mork.
Nanu Nanu.
Oh, that's cool too. Mutated Spider-Man. Some Battlestar Galactica. Cylons. Yeah, that's what they were. Everybody watching is going to be like, you idiot. You don't know Battlestar Galactica? And I'm like, no. No, I don't. I was more of a Star Wars guy. Well, so was everybody else. He won't disclose what this is for. If this is for surveillance or entertainment.
It's entertainment. I'm actually got this in there right now.
Oh, nice.
Classic.
Perfect. So you got the cabinet up here. Oh, there's a... Was it Wacky Action Leonardo?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm actually looking for the Wacky Action Shredder, but I can't find them like anywhere.
Oh yeah, I know which one.
Some G.I. Joes. Got everything down here. So like you said, he's open every Wednesday and Saturday.
Thursday.
Sorry, Thursday. Thursday. I need to pay attention better. You can also get a hold of him. I'll put the link for Instagram, Facebook. He ships. If there's anything here that you see that you like, bunch of goodies down here, some carded Power of the Force. A lot of people are getting into collecting that line because it's fairly affordable. You can have a carded collection. There you go if you want to pretend you're clearing the roads. We could have used some of these out there this morning. I didn't see a single snowplow on the way here. It was brutal. Oh, that's cool. I've got the Land Shark. That's just a neat idea. Do they have that scale?
That's great.
Is that Locutus the Borg? Or just a Borg? So there you are. That's 3D Vintage.
A cool miscellaneous shelf right there.
Yeah. Yeah, I was checking out some. I like the. Oh, is that Ian Malcolm? That's got to be Jurassic Park, right?
Yeah, Jeff
Goldblum. Oh, Jeff Goldblum, but the cool version. They had to deal him up. It was like Power of the Force or anything like that. They got to get those guys. Oh, there's a rat dude. That's from Earthworm Jim. Yeah. Oh, I need that figure, too.
Bobcat Goldthwait?
Yeah, okay.
Police Academy.
Police Academy. That's cool. Ah. I do need a Godzilla. I'll ask you about that afterwards. Actually don't have a single Godzilla in my entire collection. But there it is. If you want any of this stuff, or like, he's got you covered. If you're in the Southern Ontario region, just come on down to St. Jacobs. We got some bag goodies here. Rio Blast, Trap Jaw. Who doesn't like Trap Jaw? He's got that little bubble blower on the top of his head there. Rat Lore, all sorts of stuff. Oh, there's an awesome 90s Egon. Some Toy Biz stuff. Got bins of WWE here. A lot of people collect those.
All kinds of miscellaneous stuff.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what you're into, this booth has probably got it in some capacity. All right, dude, it was awesome checking out your booth, but I think it's time to turn off the camera and make some deals.
All right, man.
Cool.
Take care.
Peace. Okay, so we're down at St. Jacobs. I could have probably stayed at 3D Vintage and talked toys all day. There's a super center nearby. So we're going to go into this Walmart and check out what they've got. I don't have a lot of high hopes. I usually strike out at Walmart, but let's go check it out anyway. So, we're in the toy section. This is like a super messy Walmart. Just kick around. Well, imagine that. They still have Eternals figures. A few Transformers here. Like I said, this Walmart is like super messy. They've got toys like every aisle. There's no rhyme or reason to what's going on here, it seems. But I think I'm definitely going to pick up that guy. I need that one. That's cool. Nothing else. I do need that wreck car. but at $47, I don't know. I'll have to think about that one. Let's grab it for now. DC, don't collect that line too hard, but here they are. Yeah, not a great selection at this Walmart, but I think I am going to pick up this guy, this 40th He-Man, because I still need him. And I'm not into wrestling, but I like getting this stuff for my Marvel Legends dioramas, so I will grab this too. So let's head off to the next place, because, yeah, I'm done here. So I thought I'd stop by a Toys R Us in Kitchener. This is where rich people in Canada go to buy toys. I haven't been here in months. These guys are notorious for gouging. They're charging like $44 Canadian for a standard Marvel Legend. But you never know, maybe something's on clearance or I can get a deal. And I also need to use the washroom. So let's go check out this Toys R Us. This place is stacked with stuff because it's too expensive. I need this, but it's so expensive. I think I'll grab it before it's gone and then I regret it. Oh, Eternals on clearance. That's a clearance price. Oh my god.
Completion. I'll be waiting.
McFarland's about the only thing here that's a normal price. I don't know, Toys R Us, maybe you should lower your prices so you can sell stuff. That's crazy. Crazy, crazy. Yeah, Americans aren't really losing out too much on Toys R Us, I don't think. Place is freaking expensive. I think that's all I'm going to get, and I'm not sure I want to pay that much for it, but I need it. So I had a quick Kijiji stop. I nailed this down for $15, so pretty happy with that. Yeah, so I'm off to the next place. So I'm here at one-of-a-kind antiques in Woodstock. This is one of my usual haunts. We'll go inside and check out some of my favorite booths.
So
All right, so we're gonna say goodbye to the antique warehouse. It's almost 1 o'clock p.m. I've been at this since about 6 this morning, so I'll do a recap when I get home, but that's 7 hours of toy hunting down. And I will see you in a bit. All right, so I made it home safe and sound. So yeah, I'm just gonna do a bit of a recap here. So this is the stuff that I got from 3D Vintage at St. Jacobs. Rob gave me a really good deal. I was looking for Crasher for a long time. Not sure what his name is, but I don't have him. And a vintage Egon, which I also needed. And Rob also is in a movie called Playtime. I'm gonna put the link to his the trailer and stuff like that, also the link to his Instagram. If you see anything in the video that you liked at his shop, you can get a hold of him, and he does ship. So next thing is, I did like a Kijiji run while I was in Woodstock. The guy was asking 20 for this. I offered him 15 and he took it, so that's kind of cool. I don't know much about the 2000X line. I really like the reboot cartoon, but yeah, I don't know much about it. I know he's missing his helmet, and I think he had like, that's not the right He-Man for this battle cat, and I think he has a whole bunch of swords. I'll have to like look him up later, I'm not sure. So at the Walmart that I stopped at, the only thing that I ended up walking away with was this 40th He-Man, because he ended up being on sale for 20 bucks, which is actually a pretty decent price in Canada. So yeah, I picked that up. And then at the Toys R Us, I picked up the Ghost Rider vintage card. I didn't want to pay 37 bucks, like that was crazy, but for some reason Big Bad Toy Store canceled my order, or my pre-order. It just didn't go through. And I'm having a hard time finding this guy right now for a reasonable price. I think I saw him on Amazon for like 60 some bucks, and I'm not paying that. And another one, this guy was 22 bucks, Axe Wolves. Another one that I don't see anywhere but at Toys R Us. Like, I don't know, it's pretty easy to find stuff there if you want to pay for it, because the prices are so high, I don't think anything really moves too quickly there. No sales at Toys R Us today, which is unfortunate, but you know, even sale price in the, when you look back in the video, isn't really that great. So at the antique warehouse, I picked up a few random things. So at that antique warehouse, I picked up a few random things. So I got the Forearm Ben 10 guy. He'll look good in one of my dioramas. I like grabbing stuff like that that's weird that can fit in with the diorama. And this robot, I thought he just looked cool. He's gonna look neat in the diorama. I have no idea what he is. And then I'm always picking up these 2011 Thundercats to do customs with. I'm trying to finish out that line with customs. And then I ended up finding this Bionic 6 guy. I've got one other one. He's somewhere on my table here. Yeah, can't find him right now, but yeah, I've ended up picking up another one. These guys are like super heavy and metal and like, holy cow. Yeah, kind of neat, kind of interesting line. But yeah, so that was my 7 hours cruising around looking for toys. And yeah, like I said, check out Rob's stuff in the description. And I guess that's it for now. So take her easy.